गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन एंड वेलकम टू द क्लास. वी हैव स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर न्यू क्वेश्चन एंड आइडियाज इन आर हिस्ट्री बुक. सो ऑल ऑफ यू टेक आउट योर हिस्ट्री बुक एंड ओपन दिस चैप्टर न्यू क्वेश्चन एंड आइडियाज. एंड अंडर दिस चैप्टर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट गौतम बुद्धा, हिज लाइफ एंड हिज टीचिंग्स. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑल दीज थिंग्स. And when we were discussing his life, we came to know that his another name was Siddhartha, and he belonged to a royal family. He belonged to a Gana, and that the name of the Gana was Sakya Gana. Though he was a prince, he belonged to a royal family, but he was not happy with the comfort and luxuries of life, and that is the reason that in his young age he left his house, he left his palace, he left his home, because he wanted to get knowledge, he wanted to attain knowledge. So in search of knowledge he left his house, and then he wandered from one place to another, and then he started meditation. He did meditation at Gaya, that is in Bihar. He sat under a peepal tree and kept meditating for so many days. And after several days of meditation, he attained enlightenment. And from that day, he was called Buddha, the wise one. जिसे ज्ञान हो गया है, जिसे बुद्धि हो गई है, okay? And the place where he was meditating, that place came to be known as Bodh Gaya, and the peepal tree under which he was meditating, that tree is known as Bodhi Vriksha. Okay, and after attainment of enlightenment, he started spreading the knowledge to the people. And he wandered from one place to another and spread the knowledge, spread the teachings, and he was lastly he died at Kusinar. And then we have also seen his teachings. The most important teaching of Gautam Buddha was that life is full of unhappiness and sufferings. Why life is full of unhappiness and sufferings? Because of tanha or thirst. This tanha or thirst is the unending desires. Our desires are unending, and because of these unending desires, our life is full of sufferings and unhappiness. And in order to be happy, what is required? That we must be moderate in everything. These are the teachings of Buddha. Other than this, Buddha has also taught that we should be kind to all the living beings, including the animals. And he was also of the opinion, it was his teaching, that whatever we do, that which is called karma, है ना, हम जो भी करते हैं उसको हम कर्मा कहते हैं. एंड दिस कर्मा अफेक्ट आर प्रेजेंट लाइफ एंड द नेक्स्ट लाइफ ऑल्सो. सो वी शुड वी मस्ट ट्राई टू डू गुड कर्म. ओके, एंड देन ही हैज ऑल्सो ही टॉट द पीपल इन द लैंग्वेज ऑफ देयर ओन लैंग्वेज. मीन्स that Gautam Buddha taught in the language of ordinary people, and that language of ordinary people was Prakrit. We know that at that time the Vedic religion, which was prevalent, in Vedic religion the hymns were in Sanskrit, and the Brahmins were the they did everything regarding the worship and ritual in Sanskrit only, and Sanskrit was not the language of common people. But what we find, Prakrit was the language of common people. So we see that people were very much attracted towards Buddhism, because they were very much able to understand the teachings of Buddha. Not only this, teachings of Buddha was based on the reason. He never asked people to follow him blindly. He always asked them to follow them if they feel that I am saying the right thing, if they feel that whatever Buddha is saying is true according to reason. And in this regard, we have seen the story of Kisa Gotami, how he was able to convince, he was able to make Kisa Gotami accept the hard realities of life, that the death is the ultimate truth of life. So these are the teachings of Buddha, and his methods were also very such methods were adopted by him that made him very popular among the common people. Okay, now we will consider another school of thought, and that is called Upanishad. Okay, Upanishads. So what we find, around the time that the Buddha was preaching, and perhaps a little earlier also, other thinkers also tried to find answers to difficult questions. So the chapter, the name of the chapter, you can see, New Questions and Ideas, isn't it? So what is the theme of the chapter? I told you earlier also that this was the time when so many changes were taking place in the life of common people. So such a big kingdoms like Mahajanpads were started to grow, and with these Mahajanpads the life was changing very fast, not only in cities but also in villages. So what we find that these changes were compelling some people to think in a different direction. Some new questions arose in their mind, like questions regarding life, questions regarding the purpose of life, what happens after death. So like these questions started to come in the minds of the people. Some people, these people are thinkers, and Buddha was one among them. So we see that other than Buddha, there were other thinkers also, there were other peoples also who started to think in that direction. Okay, some of them wanted to know about life after death. What happens after death? Is there life after death? Okay, there were some who wanted to know what is the utility of sacrifices. At that time, in a Vedic religion, sacrifice was very popular. People used to do sacrifices, and it was believed that they will be benefited by performing these sacrifices, and these were done by Brahmanas. But there were some who started to question the utility of these sacrifices. And now there were some thinkers who started to think that there was something which is permanent in the universe. Because our life is not permanent. We are in this world for a particular duration of time. We are not the permanent feature of the universe. We will die after some time, and that's all about us. But there is something in the universe which is permanent, which never dies, isn't it? So this type of thinking was generating in the mind of many people, and they thought that the thing about which they are saying that something is permanent in the universe and that never dies, jo kabhi nahi marta hai, jo hamesha zinda rehta hai. Okay, and what was that? They described this as atma or individual soul. Okay, so this was atma or individual soul. Atma or individual soul. So it was the opinion of such thinkers that our body dies, but our soul never dies, isn't it? Hamari atma jo hai wo kabhi nahi marti, hamare body death hota hai. And in the similar way, other than this atmana or individual soul, there was one more thing, and that was brahmana. Brahmana or universal soul. Okay, so this is the soul of a single person, individual soul, isn't it? And Brahmana is the universal soul. This is the soul of the whole world. And what was these thinkers believed, that what happens, that ultimately this Atmana and Brahmana were one. Atma jo hai wo Brahmana mein mil jati. Okay, you don't need to understand too much these philosophies, because these are very philosophies of very high level. You just understand that these people, these thinkers were of the opinion that there is something in the universe which is permanent. And what is permanent? This individual soul and universal soul, both these are permanent. They always remain, they never dies. Okay, so this individual soul, which is called Atmana, and universal soul, which is called Brahmana, these two are permanent. And one more thing, ultimately what happens, that this individual soul meets the universal soul. This individual soul and universal soul are one. Sab milkar ek ho jate, jo bhi atma hai wo parmatma mein mil jati hai. Okay, so this is these were the thoughts which were prevalent, which was started to grow at that time. Okay, so ultimately they believed that Atmana and Brahmana were one. Atma jo hai wo Brahmana mein mil jati hai. Okay, now we will see that many of such ideas regarding this whatever we are discussing, these ideas were recorded in Upanishads. These are the Upanishads. Okay, so thoughts like this are recorded in Upanishad. They are written in Upanishad, and these Upanishads are part of later Vedic text. We have discussed na, there are four Veda, Rig Ved, Sam Ved, Yajur Ved, Athar Ved. You must remember, na, char Vedas hai, Rig Ved, Sam Ved, Yajur Ved, Athar Ved. Okay? इसमें हम क्या देखते हैं, आई एम राइटिंग द नेम ऑफ ऑल द वेदास, ऋग्वेद, सामवेद, यजुर्वेद एंड अथर्ववेद. What we find, this Rig Veda is the oldest, है ना? पहला वेद जो है वो यही है, Rig Veda. This, the period in which this Rig Veda was written, that is known as Vedic period. And these three texts, when these three texts, this is early Vedic period, okay? When these Vedas, we are dividing these Vedas into two parts, okay? The first part is Rig Veda, okay? When Rig Veda was written. The time when Rig Veda was written, this time is known as early Vedic period. Early Vedic period. Okay? And the time when these three Vedas, Sam Ved, Yajur Ved and Athar Vedas were written, this period is known as later Vedic period. Later Vedic period. जो फर्स्ट वेदा है वो कौन सा है, वो ऋग वेदा है. और जिस पीरियड में वो फर्स्ट वेदा लिखा गया उसको हम क्या कह रहे हैं, उसको हम कह रहे हैं अर्ली वैदिक पीरियड. ठीक है, अर्ली पहले वाला. ओके, एंड देन दीस थ्री वेदा, सामवेद, यजुर्वेद एंड अथर्ववेद, दीस वर रिटन आफ्टर दिस ऋग वेदा. एंड द टाइम व्हेन दीस थ्री वेदास वर रिटन, दिस इज नोन एज लेटर वैदिक पीरियड. ओके, and these Upanishads, in these Upanishads new ideas are written because of changes, whatever changes was happening in the society, because of these changes so many new questions were arising in the mind of thinkers, so many new ideas were generating in the mind of thinkers. So these new ideas, these new questions, all these are recorded in Upanishads, and these Upanishads are part of later Vedic text. This later Vedic period, these are later Vedic text, and Upanishad is also one of the later Vedic text. Okay, now we will try to understand the meaning of Upanishad. The literal meaning of Upanishad is approaching, Upanishad, approaching and sitting near. Okay, so what is the meaning of Upanishad is approaching, अप्रोच करना, पास जाना, अप्रोचिंग एंड सिटिंग नियर. ओके, दिस इज द मीनिंग, लिटरल मीनिंग ऑफ Upanishad. एंड इन दीज Upanishads व्हाट वी फाइंड, देयर इज कन्वर्सेशन between teacher and students. The all the text in Upanishad is in the form of conversation, dialogues, you know, In Rigveda also we have seen the all the content were in the form of dialogues and conversation. And in Upanishad also we find that there is conversation between the teacher and the students. And whatever ideas are presented in the Upanishad, they are simple dialogues. जैसे कोई कुछ कह रहा है, उसके जो वर्ड्स हैं, जो डायलॉग्स हैं, उसमें ही सारे जो आइडियाज हैं वो हमें देखने को मिलता है, पढ़ने को मिलता है. ओके, सो दिस इज उपनिषद. इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ लेटर वैदिक टेक्स्ट. ओके, एंड वी सी दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द उपनिषदिक थिंकर्स वर मेन, बिकॉज एट दैट टाइम ऑल्सो वी फाइंड दैट there was a kind of differentiation was there on the basis of gender. So we see that most of the Upanishadic thinkers were men, and these men mostly belonged to Brahmins and Rajas also. Okay, so the Upanishadic thinkers were men, and these mostly men. And these men belong to Brahmanas or the Rajas. Okay. Occasionally there is some mention of some women thinkers also, and there is one very popular woman thinker, and her name is Gargi. So who was Gargi? She was She was a woman Upanishadic thinker, and she was very much famous for her learning. She was a very learned person. She was famous for her learning, and she also participated in the debates, and these debates which usually happened in royal courts. So she was very much popular among the people. Okay, but there were very few women Upanishadic thinkers were there at that time. Okay, and we also find that these Upanishadic thinkers not only belong to the male members of the society, but also there was a kind of division between rich and poor also, because most of the time we see that these Upanishadic thinkers did not belong to the poor families. Mostly they belong to well-off families, but there is one example. There is one poor Upanishadic thinker was, and his name was Satyakama Jawala. So these are exceptions. In general, what was the trend? The trend was that the Upanishadic thinkers will be men. The Upanishadic thinkers will belong to Brahmanas and Rajas, and these Brahmanas and Rajas were the if we see it through the economic status, we see that these Brahmanas and Rajas belong to the rich section of the society. So this was the trend, but there was some exception. The first exception we have seen Gargi, because she was a woman Upanishadic thinker, and now we will see that Satyakama Jawala. Okay, this Satyakama Jawala, this name, the name which we are seeing, Jawala, Satyakama Jawala, he derived his name from his mother Jawali. Okay, and his mother was a slave. We have discussed about the dasas and dasis were there who were not treated as human being, but they were treated as object, है ना? तो they were the poorest section of the society. So her this Satyakama Jawala's mother was a slave, and her name was Jawali. And from this Jawali, his name is Jawala, Satyakama Jawala. So it was not a very simple achievement. We cannot say it a simple achievement. It was a great achievement at that time, that a woman who is a slave and her son is one of the Upanishadic thinkers. He became one of the Upanishadic thinkers. So it was a great achievement. And this happened only because of the spirit. There was desire, there was wish, है ना? उसके अंदर चाहत थी और उसकी जो इच्छा थी उसको उसने पूरा किया. दैट इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट कि हमारे अंदर इच्छा शक्ति होनी चाहिए, विल पावर होनी चाहिए. इफ वी हैव विल पावर, वी कैन ओवरकम ऑल द हर्डल्स. जितने भी रास्ते में हमारे हर्डल्स आएंगे, हम सबको दूर कर सकते हैं, सबको हम जीत करके आगे बढ़ सकते हैं, अगर हमारे अंदर सच्ची चाहत है तो. सो वॉट इज रिक्वायर्ड इन लाइफ, दैट वी मस्ट हैव विल पावर, वी मस्ट हैव डिज़ायर्स कि हमें ऐसा करना है, है ना? सो सत्यकामा जवाला, ही हैड अ डीप डिज़ायर टू लर्न अबाउट रियलिटी. And his desire was so deep that one Brahmin teacher accepted him as his students. Normally what happens that a Brahmin teacher never accept a person belonging to lower caste or a person who is a slave, dasyu, as their student. They rarely accept such people as their students. But in this case, what we find that Satyakama Jawala, he was very much, he has the desire to learn about realities. And his desire was so deep that he was accepted as a student by a Brahmin teacher. And the name of the teacher was Gautama. Okay, this Brahmin teacher Gautam accepted Satyakama Jawala as his student, and after becoming the student of Gautama, Satyakama Jawala became one of the best known thinkers of the time. So this is the these are the exceptional cases where we find that people belonging to, like a woman, she is becoming Upanishadic thinker. Then Satyakama Jawala, who was the son of a slave, now he becomes a Upanishadic thinker. So these are the exceptional cases. Okay, we see that whatever is the ideas of the Upanishadic thinkers, these ideas were started at this time only, but they used to grow. वो आगे बढ़ते गए, उनका ग्रोथ होता गया इस आइडिया का. एंड लेटर दिस आइडिया ऑफ उपनिषदिक थिंकर्स वर डेवलप्ड बाय शंकराचार्य, जगत गुरु आदि शंकराचार्य. ही डेवलप्ड दिस आइडिया एंड ही इज द वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट फिलोसोफर ऑफ Hinduism, and you will learn about this Shankaracharya in your next class, in class 7th. Okay, you will learn about the views of Shankaracharya, which is very important. Okay, So this is all about Upanishadic thinkers. Okay, you have to remember, you have to understand the things. Okay, so today this is all, and now we will continue our study in next class.